Kenya's arid north has been hardest hit by the drought. Farmers are now trying to find alternatives in order to survive. Around 30,000 herders have already crossed into Uganda, grazing their animals in the Moroto district.
I traveled a long distance from Kenya, following rivers along the way. But whenever we settle in a new place, we soon run out of water and grazing land. It's too dry for our animals.
Farming communities have already migrated. Some are in Uganda, others in South Sudan. So when we have stock, we don't have customers to sell it to. The goods don't move.
Kenya recorded low rainfall in October and November, and the next rains are only due in April. It's prompted the government to seek longer-term solutions to the problem.
We are now embarking on major big dams. If we are able to do that and successfully dig the big dams, then we should be able to retain our pastoralists in our own country.
3 million Kenyans will continue providing food and cash transfers. We intend to mobilize water bowsers and trucks from the public institutions and also from our army, from NYS. We also want to upscale on livestock offtakes for cattle, and we have gone now further to also undertake offtake on sheep and goats, particularly in areas where the markets are now dysfunctional.
The government has also set aside about $70 million for drought mitigation efforts. Leslie Marungu, CGTN.